The task blocks at GDQs really are amazing. And if you don't believe me, just ask the GDQ committee, who keeps incorporating it into their schedules. For the tens of thousands of people who tune into these events, and some of the speedrunners too, TASes are eye-opening. It's just incredible to see what some of these games look like when they're pushed to their limits. People obviously want to see these runs because most of the TAS runs in the schedule are hidden behind bonus incentives, where everybody has to donate a certain amount for it to be actually part of the schedule. But these donation goals continue to be met, so obviously, everybody enjoys them. I think everybody who works with TASBot and TASBlock and GDQs has done something good not only for the speedrunning community, but for the whole world as well.
So I think one of the great things about the TASBot community is that the whole team brings a different level of dedication to what they do. Dwango especially at each GDQ clearly is spending time around the clock trying to get everything prepared to put on the best show possible. And there's such a fascinating commitment to entertainment, even when it diverges a little bit from speedrunning proper. It is a different approach, I think, to TASing, to really show people what's possible in a completely different way. And I think that that's one of the things that makes TASBot and the TASBot community really special.